So welcome to all of you, and the young people will be
thank you.
Jesus said, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. This is the first and great commandment. And the second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments depend all the law and the prophets." Let us call to mind and confess our sins. We pray as a community, Almighty God, our Lord and Father,
we
make
sins to confess and we have sinned against you. Through our own fault, we thought, word, and deed, and we want to be done for the sake of your Son, Christ our Lord.
A reading from Hebrews chapter 12, You have one promise of something that can be touched, a blazing fire and darkness, and gloom and tears, and the sound of a trumpet and the voice of whose words may the years be that not another word be spoken to them, for they could not endure the order that was given. If even an animal touches the mountain, it shall be stoned to death. Indeed, so terrifying was the sight that Moses said, I tremble with fear. But you have come to Mount Zion and to the city of the living.
Thank you.
She was bent over and was quite unused to her sleep. When Jesus saw her, he called her over and said, "Woman, you are set free from the demon." Then he laid his hand on her, immediately she stood up straight and began to walk. But the leader of the synagogue immediately knew that because Jesus had cured on the day, he kept saying to the crowd, "There are 6 days on which work to be done. Come on those days and be cured, not on the Sabbath day." But the Lord answered him and said, "You hypocrites, does not each of you on the Sabbath night his ox or his donkey from the manger and lead it away to give the Lord? And though not this woman, a daughter of Abraham, who sate in bond for 18 years, which he longed, but set free from the bandage on the Sabbath day. Let me speak this, all of his countrymen were put to shame, and the entire crowd was rejoicing at all the wonderful things that he was doing." This is the gospel of Christ.
Praise to Christ, our Lord.
Let us reaffirm our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed.
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father, through whom all things are made, for us and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit, and in the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified and Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the Lord of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Before I start my sermon this morning, I would just like to thank the person who gave me the opportunity to speak to you. And I speak in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Keep me seated. So when I was coming up with this sermon, it was quite a challenge for me, considering that normally when I do speeches, there's only a certain topic. With the sermon, it was just a broad thing. So I remember doing the lesson course during this year. It was the first time I ever attended it, and I didn't know what I was missing out on until this year. A lady said to me, "God will not take you to something if he cannot take you through something." And that statement really stuck on me, because as people, we tend to give up on the first hurdle, the first obstacle, the first challenging act. And all for what? Why throw your dreams and aspirations all away because of one challenge, in which you'll probably forget about in the next 2 years or so? And when you do overcome the challenges, it is the greatest achievement ever. The youth is a great example of this, because yes, we understand that school is tiring. I, as a grade 11 student, can definitely put myself in motion, because every day I have sports, I have academics, and it is, I feel as if there's like a million things on my plate, and I have to get all of them done by a certain period of time, or else I'll start to lack, and if I lack, I then tend to fumble. Yes, it gets difficult, but look at the future. When you have your dream house, you have your dream car, you are walking in materialistic things. But what about God? He We shan't obtain your best things in life, or we wish to have it. Did you thank him for helping you overcome your challenges? Did you thank him for where you are now? Or even did you realize that he helped you overcome those challenges? As a youth, including myself, I feel as if we tend to drift away from God, especially because we become so involved with materialistic things that we forget about the spiritual side sometimes. We become so fixated on the world around us, our Instagram likes, our Instagram followers, following the latest trends, wanting to be popular. But why don't we spend this time with God, making memories with our families that will cherish forever? Why are we so quick to say gossip? Speak about other things, but not about God. Why don't we want to be healthy in the spirit? Why don't we learn Bible verses like we know the lyrics to our favorite song? Are we ashamed? Am I ashamed? Will I not fit in? Will we not fit in? But who cares? Because all those things, they don't know you the way God knows you. I'll be honest, during a period of my life, I drifted away from God. Especially when something tragic happened to my family or something tragic happened to me. And this was the time where I was supposed to lean on God. I was supposed to look to God to be my refuge. But instead, I drifted away from God. I am not proud of that. However, I can overcome that by becoming closer to God each and every single day. Those people that turn their backs on you when you did something wrong. Yes, I was lost. Yes, I try and better my relationship with God, but it is very difficult, especially when we're surrounded by things in which we feel, in which we touch, in which we can see. In our daily lives, we're surrounded by objects. I know I am not perfect. I know sometimes myself and maybe other people sitting here. We run to God when it's convenient to us, when we are in distress, but it's time for change. Time to rebuild our relationship with God. Either by reading a Bible, singing praise and worship, or just by doing a simple good deed. In the first reading, it stated, "See, today I appoint you over nations and over kingdoms to pluck down and to pull up, to destroy and to overthrow, build and to plot and to plant. Leave the old ways and focus on the new. God took you through so many challenges. Don't drift away from God when we have succeeded and when we have received what you wanted. For he is the one that will never not deserve us. He is the one that helps us overcome those challenges. Amen."
Let us pray. Jesus said, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God. Trust also in me. This is the Lord's promise, and to whom we now offer our prayers." As we celebrate the Holy Eucharist to the glory of God and in thanksgiving for his mercies, let us pray for the church and for all God's people according to their needs. Almighty God, we pray for your church. We ask that you give our church the boldness and confidence to proclaim the gospel of Christ and declare God's glory among all nations. We pray for these dioceses, for Steve, our bishop, Tawa, our metropolitan, Douglas, our rector, and the clergy, and all ministers of your word. We ask that you grant and guide them with wisdom and discernment as they teach your living word and serve your Lord in your name.
Amen.
We also pray for the youth. We ask you to reveal your word in them. Help them find faith in you, and may they grow in grace and be used by you to witness the truth of your word to others and shine as your light to the world, Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
God, the heavens and earth belong to you. We pray for the nations of the world and the leaders and all those in authority that they may honor one another and seek common good. Direct them in all that they do so that justice would be maintained, the innocent defended, and wickedness restrained, freedom upheld, and integrity battered. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Lord, in a world full of uncertainty and confusion, we lift up to you. We ask that you guide them, enable them to triumph over failure and frustration,
when faced with many burdens of this world. Give them courage to overcome and to hold fast their faith and trust in you. Lord, in your mercy.
Our great physician, hear our prayers for those who are sick, and we especially remember those on the room from Radon, Adolph and Veronica Dillon, and John Robertson, who is at home recovering from the arm to his back. There are any other, please name them. Lord, bestow your power of healing upon the sick. We ask that you nourish, strengthen, and restore them in health according to your will. We give you thanks for the care and dedication for those who care for them. Listen to them in your abundant goodness. We pray for our youth. We ask you grant them good and health in physical, emotional, and mental state. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, you promise never to forsake us. You are our defender and shield for those who need. We pray for those in trouble, sorrow, need, or any others. Lord, we ask you to be given hope as they face the challenges of life. Reassure those who are despairing. Be with those who are lonely. Defend the weak and hear the voice of all who call upon your saving name. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Lord, we pray especially for our youth. We ask you to draw closer to them as they seek you more in their days. May they learn to lean and trust in you, knowing that your grace is sufficient for all needs. We pray that you God grant them wisdom and understanding in their academic as they write their various examinations, especially the matriculants who are starting their prelims. Guide and direct them in the subjects that they are studying or the choices that they will make when they choose their career path or face with difficult decisions to your praise and glory. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Loving God, we pray for our families and children and those with special claims upon us. Give grace to those whose lives are closely linked with ours, and that we may serve Christ in him and love one another as he loves in us. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Eternal God, we praise and thank you for your servants who have gone before us. According to your promises, grant us with him a share in your eternal kingdom. Merciful Father, accept these, our prayers, for the sake of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Is anybody celebrating a birthday or anniversary, traveling, going to the hospital perhaps? Just a reluctant hand. Are you a birthday? Okay. And are you celebrating your birthday? Very nice. How old are you going to be? How old are you? Notices that I have, and one
Father died, he needs prayers. He's not well. He was actually due to preside today, but he's asked me to do it. So he will see the doctor tonight, but keep him in the prayers in the meantime, please. He's asked me to apologize, give his apologies to the parents of those that he was due to meet after this service, the parents of the covenant. So I'm sorry, that meeting won't happen today, but it will be rescheduled, and I'm sure he told me about it. Okay, so the confirmation classes do meet today after the service. If you've not signed up yet, please, you may still do so. Please attend and come and add the details to the list. Also, to say that there's a quiet warning for the confirmants. You are being confirmed this year and the new year. And this will be at St. Michael's on Saturday the 24th of September, so that's in a month's time, from 7:30 to 8. It will be followed by a bride and fellowship with your families. So it is compulsory to be Then other notices, fundraising. As you know, we have a jumble service coming Saturday. Please join us if you're able to. It starts at 9 o'clock. And please spread the word so that we have enough people coming. I think that there's a lot of stuff. Sacristan is a wonderful ministry where you prepare the altar for the services. So if you feel called to this ministry, the people sacristans will be very happy, and Estelle will be very happy to train you. So please contact either Estelle or Ben in the office or others. The Acts team are looking for an unused working sewing machine. So if you're able to help with that, please speak to any member of the Acts team or get the phone to your office. Would you please stand for the
Christ is at peace. He has reconciled us to our Lord. In one body by the cross. We meet in his name and share in his peace. So peace of the Lord be with you all.
Peace be with you.
all that, the heaven and earth are yours, yet you have given us dominion over all things. Receive the fruits of our labor, offered in love, in the name of Jesus Christ, Son.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given, and human hands have made, for us it becomes the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands, for us it becomes the cup of salvation. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give you thanks and praise.
We give you thanks and praise, Almighty God, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, our Saviour and Redeemer. He is your living Word, through whom you have created all things. By the power of the Holy Spirit, He took flesh of the Virgin Mary and shared our human nature. He lived and died as one of us to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. In fulfillment of your will, he stretched out his hands in suffering to bring release to those who face their personal grief. And so he won for you a holy people. He chose to bear our griefs and sorrows and to give up his life on the cross, that he might shatter the chains of the evil one and banish the darkness of sin and death. By his resurrection, he brings us into the light of your presence. And so now, full creation, we raise our voices to proclaim the glory of your name.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of our hands, the heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed be the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest.
Holy and gracious God, accept our prayers through your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, who on the night that he was handed over to suffering and death, took bread and gave you thanks, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is broken for you." In the same way, he took the cup, saying, "This is my blood, which is shed for you. When you do this, you do it in memory of me." So we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ is alive, Christ is risen, Christ will come again.
Remembering therefore the day of the resurrection, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you that you have made us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. We ask you to send your Holy Spirit upon the offering of your Holy Church. Gather into one all who share in these sacred mysteries, filling them with the Holy Spirit and confirming their faith in you, that together we may praise you and give you glory through your servant, Jesus Christ. All glory and honor are yours, Father and Son, with the Holy Spirit, is the Holy Church, now and forever.
Is it not a sharing of the body of Christ?
We are one in all.
Thank you. Yeah.
And now the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son,